First Minister.
Yes, sir.
An accompaniment, if you will. My wardrobe is extensive. My socks are from Peru. My knickers drawers are full to bursting, all in a fetching blue. I have tuxedos aplenty and a fine array of hats.
Oh, very good.
But a tour around my dressing room leaves my mood awful.
Flat.
I hate my socks.
He hates his socks.
I hate my shoes.
He hates his shoes.
And this sombrero poncho combo leaves me blue.
He leaves him blue.
I want pizzazz.
He wants pizzazz.
I want chutzpah.
He wants chutzpah.
I want a southern look that leaves my people shook. My tailors are abysmal, my weavers wear a flop, my woolly jumper maker is begging for the chop. I have ties in every colour, from pink to leopard skin. Not so happy for the leopards, but for me it was a win-win. I hate my hats, oh god, my pants.
Oh god, those hats.
What was I thinking with this pair of leather chaps?
We do not know.
What do you think?
What do you think
of this in pink?
Well, win-win-win.
I want to find some clothes that don't completely stink.
Versace, Valado, Dolce & Gabbana, Missoni, Armani, Prada, Valentino.
My hallway's full of dresses, my bathroom's full of shoes, my kitchen's full of baseball caps, it's too much to peruse. These buttons do not please me, they came from Savile Row. This skirt, however, is divine, it was Marilyn Monroe's. I hate this fan. Oh, what a cad. And you thought the man de Marcos had it bad. I need the best.
He needs the best.
Best of the rest.
Best of the rest.
I need a vest to complement my royal chest. I cannot cope.
We'll have a hope.
There is no hope.
No, no, no.
And if this doesn't stop, then someone's for the chop. Chop, chop. Chop, chop, I said, First Minister.